All right, so yeah, I have a little clarification I haven't really made. Back to the bicycles, back to France, back to the cars that were destroyed. When they broke the windshields and when they destroyed the little yellow van, so there was no way to get into it any longer. When they put something into the tank, so they did that second, so I couldn't get into it anymore. But the beginning, they put something in the tank that made it smoke so much that it didn't work. All of this happened while the rent was being paid. Okay, all of those events happened. There was no fighting, there was no friction with any landlords at that point. So I don't know how all that happened, all that Belfast occurrence. It had nothing to do with the rent. Okay, let's clarify. Alright, anyway. So I'm feeling a little attacked here. There's like fresh snags out there that are gonna, I'm sure they're taking the whole thing away. Not a fresh snag, it's a fresh tree that they've scalped, and now they're gonna kill it tomorrow, I imagine, even more so. So there's that one, and then there's a couple of trees up in that grove or whatever that have been there for, I don't know, probably 300 years or more. And it's back to somebody, I don't know, just hurting other human beings. Yeah, so, and I imagine it's for financial gain. I can only imagine it's for financial gain or for drugs. They do it for drug money, so they can buy drugs. So I that's who I'm looking at as the criminals. Now, when we're looking at our cutesy little world, back to our cutesy planet, nothing to do with me or attacks or anything personal. But I want to talk a little bit about, good gosh. Yeah, there's a giant bunch of birds out there and they're all confused. They've moved to other cypress trees. So they're feeling a little personally attacked. I'm seeing where do we go? You know, that's where we sit. That's where we sit. That's where we nest. Okay. So I'm like, well, okay, how can we fix this? Let's make a law. Let's make a pass a law. Trees cannot be cut during any nesting season. If there is a chance of a nesting bird in there, trees cannot be cut. And it's not just springtime. There are very, very high chances that there are birds out there right now in the trees that are young fledglings still. So the birds that are out there right now going, well, repopulate this tree, but everybody else is in it. You know, where am I going to go? Where am I going to go, say the birds that are homeless. They've been made homeless. So they're sitting up there. I've seen all kinds, all different sizes. You know, doves. We've got doves here. We have all kinds of birds that are homeless now. So it's kind of a tragedy. And I'm not really sure how to amend it aside from, hey, you know, make sure they can still have a nesting ground. And while their nest is there, no tree scalping, no tree branch cutting, no tree felling at all under any circumstances. And yeah, I get the feeling you people are on your own little property running around without a permit in a very highly populated area. That has to stop. The little babies here in this little community that have gotten away with and have gotten away with and gotten away with for so long, this has to stop. There are other human beings on this planet. It's not just you as a homeowner, or you as a renter, or you as a whatever getting happy with your chainsaw. Or, hey, I can dial somebody on the phone number there. It's not that. There are other human beings in the neighborhood. All right, so unfortunately, being a coloratura, everything becomes a drama terrible because I attract the birds. I attract the birds because of my high notes. There is nothing I can do about that. And so I'm like a Pied Piper in this situation. I'm a Pied Piper. I attract birds here, and the people are cutting the trees down that they put their nests in. So it's a very terrible situation for me. Because I'm here, it's not a protected ground. It's not a protected area. This is terrible. This is the worst thing ever. The arts are attacked and wildlife all at once. I mean, gee, you know, what a kudo for everybody, huh? Everybody who hates the arts and everybody who hates birds. What a wonderful, you know, was that the agenda? Was that the agenda? Was it actually kill two things, two birds with one stone? Yeah, how funny. How not funny. No, absolutely not funny. Anyway, I was just reading about, I added some links to some poachers, some tree poachers, and great, there are some wonderful people out there. I found a link, somebody in Suffolk, England. They were there, and they just got that person right there. They were on their property, you know, it was even their property, ooh, and they were cutting the trees. So they were doing all of this action, and they were apprehended. They were apprehended, and they were fined. And that was a quick judgment, and it was done. It was dealt with. So very much congratulations to Suffolk, England, for that one. For somebody being on the ball, that they could just make a phone call. And this is what we need to create here. We need to create a phone call outreach. Hey, you know, who's that guy? You know, what is it all about? Who is that person? When I lived in Utah, it was very much done that people just grabbed their chainsaws, it's Christmas time, and they went up to the mountains and grabbed a tree and hauled it back home. Do you know how many people live in Salt Lake City? You know how many human beings with chainsaws those mountains can't handle? That type of attitude is absolutely erroneous, beyond erroneous. It cannot happen. We just cannot have these types of people. They cannot do that. They cannot do that any longer. We don't have the wild spaces to just give away. So, now, oh, I did find something else. Yeah, 100. They caught 100. 100 trees were logged on Cottonwood Canyon in Utah by a fraudulent firm that went in there and just hauled trees out. So yeah, we really need a watchdog system. It happens that quick. 100 trees gone in one of the most beautiful canyons in the world. One of the most populated areas in the world also. It's absolutely an atrocity. All right, so, but it's, you know, they were caught. I'm even surprised they were caught. How are we going to create this hotline? How are we going to be able to call on the telephone and say, hey, enough, there's somebody out there doing something, and I don't think that was, you know, on the up and up. I don't think so. I need to figure out what it is all about. Yeah. Okay. So anyway, I did call the school system, and I just got a busy, constant busy, not a busy, I'm sorry, not a busy, no answer, not there, never there. A convenient, no, not there. So that was a not helpful. And it because it is a public school system, that really means that that is taxpayer money that pays for any event that goes on those premises. So every person that's a taxpayer in San Mateo, every person is paying for any tree felling on that property. You understand? So we have rights. Every single person that is a San Mateo resident has a right to say, uh-uh, you're not going to do that. All right. So we really have to. I'm really tired of this approach. Why do we have to be like this? Why are, you know? If you don't have money, if you don't have money for the Bay Area, then get out. I don't have money for it, and I'm begging to get out of here. But I have to stay here because of my dad. That's my situation, and he affords me that factor. But if you don't have the money to be in the Bay Area, then get out. Don't take our trees down. Don't use it as, hey, I need my wimpy retirement fund paid extra because I just don't like people in this community. They're too eco-friendly. Meanwhile, we need more. We need more participation. Even there, the treefinds.com. We need treefinds.com, and that'll be a fun site. We'll list all of the people who have been in the news. Tree finds, I found one out there at Woodside 3 years ago, 4 years ago, six magnolias. That's an incredible one. Somebody just moved in all of a sudden and harvested six magnolias off their property. Well, they got fined $52,000. It wasn't enough, but they were fined. So we need those types of events. We need them put on a website, treefinds.com, that type of thing. And we can go and sift through and go, who's getting fined in this community or that community? And go, well, that's an active community, Woodside. Beautiful for them. Congratulations. Congratulations to Suffolk also. And whoever the caller was in Cottonwood Canyon, Utah, congratulations to you, because they could have continued with even more trees. So congratulations to that caller. So this is what we need. We need a caller watchdog system. We need tree finds as because it what it does is it makes us excited and go, oh my gosh, it caught the perpetrator. We get excited. So ecology becomes an exciting event. To participate in ecology becomes an exciting event. You know, instead of saying, oh, bad boys, you caught them, they were all drunk on the street and they're smashing cars around. Instead of that, it's something like, oh my gosh, we got a tree poacher. We got tree haulers. We've got people that are poaching on their properties. They've been fined this much money. They've been fined that much money. That is exciting for human beings. That is extremely exciting for young people also. It gives them insight. It gives them like a fresh start in life that, yes, it's not the end of the world. It's not the end of the planet. We can still succeed, that there is going to be some hope for us. All right, so let's think about a treefinds.com website, okay? I know I've nailed that one, nailed that one, and nailed that one, but yeah. So we're talking about protected areas also for coloraturas, specifically because they are pied pipers to birds and nesting areas also. So we need protected areas for coloraturas. I know that sounds ridiculous, but it's the truth. What am I supposed to say to those little birds out there? You know? they're interested in my voice. There's nothing else I can do, you know. They're interested. Anyway, happy, happy England. Very good for you. I'm very, very proud of you today.